really trying to practice my Indian words.
I'm trying my American.
Yeah, well, I'm doing the Indian words because I'm the voice for Sony Pictures and in India, so Mahindra. I got that
one. Yeah, you got that correct.
Yeah. Mobile.
Correct.
That one took me a long time because I kept saying mobile.
They
kept
saying like potato and that.
Exactly, or tomato or tomato.
Wow.
Yeah, see? Isn't it interesting how we can speak the same language and yet we see things so differently sometimes?
I think it goes so far, I think human beings also like color.
Yes.
Religion that we kind of the whole world is fighting about.
Yeah, and if we can get over that, we might learn how to get along. But in the meantime, we use film to communicate, and you're working on some new projects. What are they?
I think film making from the beginning, cinema has been such a great platform to communicate and tell stories.
Mm-hmm.
You know, with the internet and all this web streaming, and in fact, what you guys are doing
right.
Has become even better. Projects that I've been doing earlier were in Mumbai and
commercial. Bollywood.
Yes. Okay. I mean, I love Bollywood.
Yes.
But I think it's time that we go beyond Bollywood now. Right. And I think India is ready and the world is ready, which is what we're doing now.
Mm-hmm.
In this first phase, Boom Brand Motion Pictures, which is my company, the production company,
right,
is tying up with collaborating with distributors and financiers and marketers in Los Angeles. And these films that we are bringing are perhaps, I would say, stories originating from India.
Right.
But they're more in the vein of Slumdog Millionaire or Exotic Marigold Hotel.
Things that will translate to cultures around the world,
absolutely,
regardless of geographic boundary.
Correct.
Okay.
Because I think the perception of like America is different than India. I mean, everybody's not an island man in America.
True.
Or Sex in the City is not everybody's life.
No.
So similarly, I think these films are going to hopefully be on a format which is more realistic by Hollywood and York as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there are three pictures up here. Should I talk about it? Or?
That would be a good idea. So that's why I wanted to talk to you.
All right.
Tell me about your films.
Okay. The first film is under $2 million project.
Yes.
Called Let Me Dance.
Okay.
Which
you're going to have the actress from?
Correct.
From a suit show.
Correct. Yeah, she's one of those. But I'm waiting for Kama Sutra to get over.
Yes.
Because our film, Let Me Dance, is actually about child abuse.
Oh. So it has a very strong message.
It's perhaps similar to a film which came out made by another Indian director who lived in the US, Veera Nair.
Mm-hmm.
It was called Monsoon Wedding.
Okay.
So it's fun all the way till we realize that at the end of it, there is a social issue growing up in India. Child abuse. And we're trying to make it an entertaining film, which is why we're trying to use Playboy model and Challenge Joker. So at least with the platform, people get to know what the real issues are.
Right.
Otherwise, it becomes a very hard sell a social issue. So that's how it was.
Well, I actually believe she touched on, I remember she said the name of the film when we interviewed her a couple of days ago. She was talking about a film where there was child abuse in it, and it's one of those hidden issues that for some reason people don't want to talk about, that or insanity or homelessness or even still alcohol or drug abuse. You don't think as advanced as we've become as a society, we've kind of woken up and realized that no one shows those things. No one has said, abuse me as a child.
Right. And which is why I feel whether in domestic territory like India or Asia,
mm-hmm,
or a modern society like North America or Europe, those issues are still there.
Very prevalent.
A film like A Girl with a Dragon Tattoo.
Yes. Very, very freaking edge movie for its time when it first came out. People were kind of like shocked.
Right.
Oh, that doesn't really happen.
Yes, it does.
So your other two films, are they in a similar vein, films with a message?
Most of my films will be about surviving and hope and in spite of losing everything in life, all with the courage and the choice to become who we are.
Pull up by the bootstraps and get moving again.
Exactly.
You know, it's amazing how many people in today's society, I don't know if this is true in India, but I see it happening more and more here in America, where people seem to have a sense of entitlement. Well, I went to school, so I showed them to work, gave me large sums of money, but they forgot the part about I gotta work. Or the sense of, you know, blind eye and a seer, so it's not really happening. things around them. Is it hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil?
Sadly, I see, since I travel constantly between Mumbai and Toronto and Los Angeles, sadly the consumerism of having more and doing less is coming to a country like India as well, in spite of all our spiritual so-called wisdom. I think any country, I mean, let's not be country specific, any culture, any society which starts developing, sadly starts developing consumerism, having more, and there's no limit to
less.
And then there'll be no satisfaction. Therefore, you'll have more therapists and more broken marriages and more single mothers. So, yeah, a lot of my films are about that.
Interesting. And you're right, it's not just a single of North America, because I travel a lot also, and I've seen that sense of entitlement happen in Europe. India. So it's something, maybe if anyone should take a look at what we're doing, it's filmmakers and television makers, that maybe it's time to stop making everything about gratuitous violence, gratuitous sex, and start to get into some meaningful stuff to maybe open people's eyes to things. Because we do have that power with the media.
Absolutely. I think as communicators, like you or me, I label myself as a filmmaker, you're a visual artist. Communicate with people. Millions of people to your website.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for this interview. But that's great to take this message to so many people.
Well, this will also end up on television.
Oh, great.
So we can reach an even greater reach. It's the internet, because with the internet, we know all about this.
Correct.
Now, with the internet, with a successful channel on the internet, you can have the same audience as a network television station.
Absolutely.
Put around the globe. And I think that's the beautiful thing about the great technology is, how will that impact films like yours, where now it can be seen in theaters or through distribution, video on demand, but at some point you could even be streaming this through the internet?
Yeah, I think it's a perfectly timed question, because right now I'm coming from this American Film Market Conference series about digital distribution and crowd funding. It's almost like a revision of my take on how internet, social media, web series that you are talking about,
right,
are going to be amazingly brilliant. And there's not going to be any censorship. I mean, of course, it's not going to be for violence or sexuality. But if people can use it for pornography, I'm saying, you know, it's a strong word. But why can't we use that for making this world a better place? And I think we are there. I think after whatever happened in North America in the last 5 years, across the world.
Right.
I think as filmmakers we are ready to make new kind of cinema. Keep holding on to old wisdom as well. But try to push the frontier of surviving and commonality.
Right.
Patience and acceptance.
Okay, if we can get over my government versus your government.
Correct.
Get over my God versus your God.
Correct. Absolutely.
Whether you're atheist or not, there's something, if you believe in a God of any kind or not, you can't argue that there was something greater than all of us that somehow evolved or created.
Right.
So if we can get that commonality out of the way and stop all the differences and find the similarities.
Oh, I would love to. Being a filmmaker, I'm looking forward to people in Los Angeles, some of my friends earlier, and I'm looking for more collaborators to come on the same platform. In fact, you could be our voice for this collective club.
Would love to. Thank you for the invitation. Love to. My wheels were turning, because I don't know if you know, I also produce film. And some of the projects you're working on we'll be talking about soon. It may not be right here right now. Because we don't want to give away all the secrets. But I have a feeling you and I will be working together soon.
It would
be a blessing.
Thank you very much.
Have a great day. We'll be back with more from the 34th Annual American Film Market. Let's just call it the film market, because there are people here from nearly 400 countries. I think it's over 350 countries.
Okay.
No, that's films. It's not 350 countries. I think it's 200, close to 200 countries. So there's only like 235 in the world.
I don't know. Like, a lot of people ask all these people who come here from different countries, like, who are you or who am I? I said, have you ever asked Google that? Who's Google? Google is everywhere.
Thank you. Exactly.
So let's take that.
And somebody could open a new island and make a country tomorrow. So there's people from a lot of countries around the world.
Well, we have that country. It's called Earth.
Earth. That's a good concept.
We all are similar.
Residents of the planet Earth.
Yeah.
Right. So So where do we get aliens from? We'll be back with more in a moment.
Thank you so very much. All the best.
So I'm going to hand you this, and your name and your company, and you're watching Actors Reporter.